G'day everyone, Gareth here from Organic Growing Melbourne. I've just finished one of my raised garden beds here. These are the ones I had at the other side of this fence. Making a few changes because of the chickens. They pretty much devoured the vegetables in a week. So I'm transplanting. Well, moving all these raised garden beds over the other side of the fence. Eventually got the fence painted as well. That's looking pretty good. This was the old asparagus bed I've repurposed. This will be where the grapevines will be going. These are the old, well, this is where the asparagus was. The crowns had gone right down to the bottom. They're almost a metre. Made along, you can see how it's just filled in the garden bed here. It wasn't easy. I've got three crowns here, which I dug out of that garden bed, which look alright, so I'm going to use these ones. I wish they'd been shortened a bit, but we'll put these ones in the garden bed. I've got a few now. Couldn't get all the varieties that I wanted, so we'll plant these. So I've got just some standard green asparagus like that. I think they were $6 each, and then I got a purple asparagus, a phantom variety. I think I got four of those. Three, four. All right, so I'm going to show you how to plant the asparagus. Now, there's several ways you can do it. Well, two main ways. Just dig a big hole, and then just put the crown down. Or another way is to build a trench and then sort of a mound in the middle of the trench and then lay the crown over it. But what I'll do is I'm just going to do the old dig a hole technique, which is pretty straightforward. You just get the crown out. So there's your crown. You can snip the end of these roots. Some of them are a bit damaged. Some of them see in fact rotten. Probably should use a proper tool, not scissors. But never mind, we'll put this in. So what I'm gonna do is just dig a big hole. Go, just put the actual head and the crown a little bit below. About that much below the surface. Level of the garden bed. And in here is all repurposed. So it's all from the old garden bed. And then I've got some existing mulch, which is already about a year old. It's nicely broken down. A lot of organic matter in it, nice and rich. You can see how dark it is. And then a bit of blood and bone and some chicken fertilizer, which is just in a pellet form, just to enrich it slightly. So there's one crown there. And then we'll put another one here. I haven't packed the soil down at all. want really good drainage for asparagus. It's quite a small one. This one. Again, that head, not that far under. Look at that. Just fill that in. See. Do the same about here. And when you're planting asparagus, you want it in an area. Permanent area for it. And you can plant asparagus from seed, from little tiny ferns. They're going to be about, it's going to take about 5 years to get anything worth harvesting. You'd need to let the crowns get really good and strong before you start cutting the asparagus with asparagus spears. So I recommend getting the crowns. First year I'll let the ferns grow out, get these roots established. The second year I'll harvest about 20% of them. And then let the ferns grow at the end of the season. And then you can harvest about 50%. And then following year a little bit more, but not all at once. You want to just let the ferns grow and pick the spears at the same time. You don't want to just keep on taking every spear off, or you'll end up killing them. Don't forget, a permanent spot. I know I've already dug mine out, but that's why I'm redoing it right. There we go. I'll show you the other method. I won't actually do it, I'll do just a quick demo. Essentially, you do a trench. Let's just see if that's in view of the camera. Yeah. So you do, obviously deeper than this, you do a trench, so two trenches, and then you'd have a mound, obviously get in the middle like that, and then you'd get your crown, spread it out and lay it over like that and then bury it. Right, I'm just going to do the whole method. So now we'll put the green ones in. This year we had so much rain that a few of my crowns had actually washed from all the water that we had. So biggest clowns. I do have someone hopefully getting me some white asparagus. I haven't had them before. Bit of water. One more of these. These are a no-name variety. They just got a look, see. Oh, I've got two in there. That's a bonus. Look at that. Just turn the camera around a bit. Got two, and look at that. One already growing. I'm going to put these in the same hole. If I need some room. The other three I've got. Put this one here. 1, 2, 3. About here. And you want them spread apart quite a bit because they just multiply out, get bigger and bigger, and you'll get asparagus. They'll all join up eventually. I'll just move you over this side now. Hopefully it doesn't fall over. Right, so put it here. Yep. So these are a bit bigger, these ones. These are the Mary Washingtons I've saved. You can still see some new ones coming up now. Alright. Give them a good watering as well. Remember, he's going to be around for 20, 25 years. I can't stress how important it is. Make sure it's a permanent area. That's the actual ferns. Those ones from when they grew out. And this whopper. That's just one of the ferns that's died back over the winter. Now here in Melbourne, where I am, Melbourne, Australia, you get asparagus. This will start probably coming up in about 2 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. So, and I was getting it, I'm probably getting asparagus for 8 months of the year. We're a temperate climate here. Just in the really cold part of winters when they die back here. So that's all we have. That's pretty much what we do. To plant asparagus. And then I've wiped a bit more blood and bone down as well. So we can get this water in. Sugarcane mulch. I'm just gonna a nice layer of mulch. Over this there. This is sugarcane mulch. could even just use normal hay if you wanted to. I find it a bit coarser and heavier. So I think the sugar cane mulch. The best stuff to use. And the basic one bag is quite far as well. Sorry, I'm going to move you again. Get you over this side again. That's good. So one of these bags is probably covering those three of these garden beds. I like to put it on pretty thick. Remember, well drained. Want a garden, want a bed that's full of nutrients. Organic materials. I wouldn't recommend going to a garden landscaping supply. Where they'll advertise a soil specifically for raised garden beds. I made the mistake and bought that. And excuse me. I pretty much got topsoil. It was just no nutrients in it at all. So you're having to add organic fertilizers, mulch. Trying to get all that beneficial bacteria and the worms and all the microbes into the topsoil that has no nutrients at all. And you can't really, I mean, you could use it to plant vegetables in it, but it doesn't drain very well. So I've just slowly mixed in my compost with worm castings. You could put worm castings on this as well. Actually, but we'll just leave this with this mulch on the top. I'll just go get the hose and we'll water this in. So I want to give this a really good watering. Pile the mulch down as well. Sure, we'll just put on. I've left the area for 2 more at the end there when I get these down. Again, you need to choose an area. You're not necessarily right. I don't want to give them a lot of sure when they've been in there for about 5 years. Those old ones are moving almost a meter. It's about 800. Very hard to dig out. Very hard to dig out. Move you again. Move this one in.
in with these to put your plans in. Of course, it's going to be really tempting to taste it. I'm sure if you just took off.
If you just took off.
One or two first year, I'm sure it would go. Don't bother the pan too much. Things are at their best probably until the third season. But like I said, you can harvest, you know, 15-20% of it. That will just spread over the whole season, that's what that means. This first year, I'll let the ferns dry out. The ferns will raise. Second lockdown, so it's going to be about 6 weeks. We've had a massive spike in corona cases here, so it doesn't hurt to know a little bit about growing your own vegetables. We're hoping to be about 70% sustainable in a few years with all the fruit and veg I'll start preserving and stuff. The only stuff we'll have to buy is probably meat. We're getting 3 eggs a meal, 3 eggs a day now. 2 hens are still not laying. But even though we're getting 3, that's still plenty. Every time we want to use eggs, we have enough of them. Alright, thanks for watching. Again, don't forget to like, subscribe and share. And also press that little notification bell. You'll get a reminder every time I release a new video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Bye.